climate innovation. It's a word that's thrown around a lot at climate summits. But what is it exactly? How would it benefit our climate change efforts? And why does it matter? Let's begin with the word innovation. Or actually, let's begin with the phone in your hand that you may be using to watch this video. The device has become an easy one-stop shop for so many of our needs. But it's not just the phone itself that's remarkable. It's the entire system around it, like cell towers and the internet, that give these phones the power to transmit messages from one side of the globe to the other. This whole ecosystem was made possible by decades of government investment in technology development to create the internet, policies to set the standard frequencies, partnerships with the private sector to create supply chains and build needed infrastructure. In other words, innovation. Now, climate innovation is taking these same principles and applying them to processes that are having an impact on our climate. Simply put, it's the process of creating, testing, and scaling up new climate solutions. Take one such process, right under your feet, concrete. Yes, the same kind of concrete that's in our buildings and sidewalks is responsible for as much greenhouse gas pollution as all the passenger vehicles in the world. In order to make concrete, fossil fuels are usually used to heat limestone and clay to more than 1,000 degrees Celsius, which then gives off a chemical reaction that produces more climate-warming pollution.
But that doesn't mean we're stuck. It means we need to innovate.
This is the main process used by industry, and there's broad agreement that we can do better. There are several alternative methods still in early stages of development, like using greencrete made from rammed earth or timber. Another option is sticking with the current material, but making the mixtures stronger by trapping carbon dioxide in the concrete during the drying process. This makes for stronger concrete, meaning we need less of it. And we also need to answer questions that go well beyond the technology itself. Like, what kind of jobs will it create? And will it be safe? Armed with a lot of good ideas, we then need to figure out which ones can translate into the real world. Some ideas work great in a lab, but we need to make sure they work out in our communities too. That means working hand in hand with communities who have a stake in these solutions so that they benefit everyone. And lastly, we need to ensure we have buyers for these new solutions, like green concrete. We'll need to leverage this entire innovation process from research to rollout with other climate challenges. Sustainable fuels for planes and shipping, tracking pollution from agriculture, removing carbon pollution that's already in the air. This may sound complicated, but not long ago it would have sounded complicated to surf the web from a handheld device or communicate with family across the world. Innovating new solutions doesn't just happen on its own. It takes time and a willingness to take some chances along the way.
It's one small step for man,
So let's get to work to harness new and better tools to address one of the greatest challenges of our time, supercharging progress on climate change and improving people's lives. Let's tackle this challenge head on.